Thank you. Mr. WHS by the judges' votes and the audience's text votes. The winner will receive a grand prize. Please see your program for directions.
In between each category, you will be able to get to know the boys through a video interview in which they will share their answers to a few questions. Here's our first one.
My spirit animal is bear, because I'm hungry and ferocious.
My spirit animal, I'd probably say eagle, because I'm going to soar above everybody else in this competition.
I would say my spirit animal would be a caterpillar, because first I was young and innocent, and now I'm a butterfly, beautiful and exotic.
My spirit animal is a Tyrannosaurus rex, because it's the most awesome thing that's ever existed in the history of the Earth.
My spirit animal would be Mr. Tevens.
My spirit animal would probably be a sloth because, you know, I like to sleep and I like to cuddle, so it's really
fun. Spirit animal is definitely John Cotton. I don't know if you know who that is, but if you don't, fine. Don't think I've ever seen that kid cry.
I think I have to go with a giraffe because my legs are really long and my neck isn't proportionate to my body.
Well, my spirit animal is probably my mom, actually. Like, first of all, she used to be an emergency room physician, and that's pretty hardcore. Like, I want to be that cool one day. And then also because she came to America, even though she can't really speak English, so my sisters and I could have a chance at succeeding. And you know what? Like, that's pretty admirable. Like, I want to be as good as her one day.
Steve Bishop.
That's weird. I would say Shaquille O'Neal, probably.
In a moment, we'll see the contestants in their beach wear. While they are getting ready, we would like to introduce our panel of judges.
Our first judge we would like to introduce is Officer Daplight. Officer Daplight works as the school resource officer across all the Westboro Public Schools. In his spare time, he enjoys golfing and spending time with his two sons, Adam and Jacob.
judge is a lady with calves of steel from her college days of playing volleyball. Please help me in welcoming Amber Bach. Superintendent Bach's hobbies include taking her beloved dog Gordy out for long walks on the beach and calling snow days. She can't wait to shake all the hands of the seniors at graduation.
Our third judge is our secretary, Kelly Orlando. Some of her favorite hobbies are hanging out with her kids, scrapbooking, baking, and watching reality TV shows. This is only her second year in the job, and we're very excited to have her on our panel.
so my first crush was Maddie French back in the fifth grade. We actually dated in sixth grade for a brief moment. She broke it off, must have been moving too quickly for her. We said hi in the hallways once, I think. Danced at Let's Dance. But yeah, I don't know what she was thinking there. It could have been something special, man.
Yeah, so I guess my ideal date, I would I'd take her out on the canoe. It's a nice lake, and we would just, you know, we'd paddle around and, you know, talk, I guess.
My first crush had to have been Sabine Samaha, or however you said it. Fortunately, you know, she moved away, didn't keep in touch, but no big deal. We'll see each other again. It'd have to be something chill or low-key, you know, like, helicopter ride or on my private yacht, go out to dinner, get some pizza. You know, of course I have to dress up, rock the chubbies. I mean, is there any other option?
My first crush was Erin Doyle in the second grade because she just moved here and kind of stole my heart right away. For my ideal date, I'd probably go into the city, probably see a comedy show or something, and then after that, probably go out for a nice bite to eat. Walk around the city for a little bit, take in the lights and stuff. And then obviously we go back to my house and watch a movie and probably cuddle up or something.
Oh yeah, that's Julia Marcus, yeah, kindergarten. I always wanted to play I Spy, couldn't read, she could read. Yeah. Say it's a match made in heaven. I think ideal date, I think I'd go on like a day hike or something, you know, hike out to a lake, spend the day out there, you know, just hang out, watch the water, skip rocks, you know, then put out a blanket, wait for the stars to come out in the sky.
My first crush was Keelan Baldwin back at Fales Elementary School, probably because, I don't know, I must have had a thing for red hair. I would say my ideal date would be first we go skydiving, then we land in Fenway Park throughout the first pitch, both of us. I'll throw it to Hanley Ramirez, you'd probably throw it to like Xander Bogaerts or something. Then we'd watch the game. Obviously, Poppy would hit a walk-off home run, be a great game. Buckles would throw a gem. After that, we would just walk around Boston, and that's that.
My ideal date would be like pick her up around 5:30, because you know I have to be home at 9:30 for my parents. But we would spend the first 30 minutes in the car debating where we should go eat. But it would be really cute because we both know where we want to go eat, but we don't want to make it a big deal or anything. And then finally, we would end up at this nice Italian pub on Newbury Street. And we would just dine and laugh the whole time, and all of a sudden, Mozart would be playing on the violin, and a whole sonnet would come. My first crush was Sarah Elizabeth Reddy Secor in the first grade. As soon as I saw her perfectly aligned earlobes, I just could not resist.
My first crush? Well, it's pretty embarrassing, but probably Flo from the Progressive commercials.
My ideal date would be to, you know, she'd come over and we'd stay at home. We'd get some delicious food, like spaghetti and meatballs, pizza. And then we'd marathon Rocky 1, 2, 3, 4, skip number 5, Rocky Balboa, and watch them all one night. That's my ideal date.
My first crush, I'm pretty sure, is Shay McClain in preschool. And we kissed in the unisex bathroom. What's my ideal date? Well, I would spend the day or night in the city, and then we'd go home and put on our pajamas. That one's for you, Miss Papetti.
Okay, my first crush was probably Julia Marcus. It's because in sixth grade, both of us stole Jason Roy's jacket, and we kept throwing it back to each other, like playing monkey in the middle with them, and he got really angry, and I thought it was really funny, and so did Julia. Alright, definitely going to an amusement park and going on like the most intense rides. Like, if you can't handle roller coasters, sorry, you can't handle me when you date me. And also, when we go out for dinner, probably just like a cute little cafe or something. Also, that works out because if we don't like each other, we didn't spend a lot of money on each other.
My first crush was Juliet Ross in like first grade. She was like on my soccer team or something, so that was pretty cool.
Okay, take like an Uber, right? Because Uber's really classy. And we'd take an Uber like in Boston, and we'd take it to like this back alleyway, just like, oh my god, like what's happening? It's just a back alleyway. But instead, there's a guy standing outside the door, right? And he opens the door and he's like, what's the password? And the password is Hims. And then you go downstairs and it's an underground bowling alley.
Oh, this one's embarrassing. Tiger Woods. My ideal date, I'd probably surprise her with a beta fish. Then there'd be like a lot of prolonged eye contact and tension. And then we'd sit in my car for like 4 hours, and then I'd drop her off.
For movies to reenact. Let's see if any of the contestants are red carpet material. Tensions will rise as Sam, Kyle, and John reenact a heated scene from Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 1.
Yeah.
crush, the two lovebirds take flight in a scene from The Notebook.
Is chilling by the pool or tossing the rock around, chilling with the squad.
I'd say in my free time, I like to wish three things, and that's eat food, come across, and hang my boss.
In my free time, I like to write sonnets, compose new pieces of music, sing in my local church choir, and paint lily pads with oil pastel.
Big sports, anything athletic, bowling, mini golf, good. at the game of curling, so it's a good time all the time.
What would I do in my free time? Well, if I had free time, would I be found in my room binge watching the Food Network?
Okay, well, I actually don't have that much free time right now. So, I guess when I do have free time, I like being awesome. And I actually play a lot of video games, which most people don't expect. And I do cook a lot, too.
For fun, I like to play guitar a lot. I've been playing guitar for like 8 years now. I also read a lot.
When I'm bored, I honestly just do this.
See, I'm the realist. Rep of the class of 2016, they call me Dave B, and lately, I've been thinking. It's kind of crazy this is coming to an end, so dear friends, lend your ears to me. I got a message to deliver through some poetry. Yeah. Okay. Now, I ain't stopping until I graduate. Penn State 2020, I can hardly wait. But before that, I got a dream. I got a dream that this last team can take it all away. Let the baseball boys will live to see another day. That at the end of high school it can be so pristine, so y'all can come and vibe with me on summer 16. Now when I first started practicing with Mr. WHS, it was quite the mess. But all the boys started making some progress, okay? I didn't know these guys at first, but now we're tight. It was kind of like we're out here performing tonight, all right? The first hours that we took... I keep messing up. The countless hours that we put in has formed a bond that can't be broken. So trust me when I tell you, number one has just spoken.
Woo!
6 a.m. waking up for the last time. Pack my bag, tie my shoes just the same. You know this morning to take a slow drive, 'cause I know I'm gonna savor this day. So slip. Oh, it's coming so fast, I know. Oh, it's coming, but I don't want to go. Oh, I can't seem to think. So now, it's gone. Okay. Hey, at least I'll remember the day. I've been so long, and I guess the time is right. Oh, I don't feel like wasting time. Yes, I know.
somebody hit the lights because Eric Zhu has a talent that's going to light up your night.
Thank you.
his inner Ren while he acts out the angry car scene from Footloose. Inspired by the 50 Cent song Candy Shop. We hope you find it just as informative as we do.
I'm trying. the learning spot. I'll let you drink the soda pop. Go ahead, girl, don't you stop. Keep going till you learn a lot. Oh, take me to your learning shop. I get my grades on the spot. Now teach me all you got. Keep going till I learn a lot. Oh!
Kyle will be paying tribute to his musical idol tonight, Ariana Grande, in his rendition of Break Free.
Prior to tonight, you were asked to prepare a lip-sync performance of Break Free by Ariana Grande. Ladies, this is your last chance to impress me and save yourself from elimination. The time has come to lip-sync for your life. Good luck. And don't f*** it up.
Stronger than I've been before. This is the part when I break free, 'cause I can't resist it no more. Stronger than I've been before, this is the part when I break free, 'cause I can't resist it no more. No, baby. Resist it no more.
My biggest fear would have to be of mice. It was because when I was younger, a mouse came up to me and it ran up my leg, and I freaked out and I cried. And so now, every time I see a mouse, I freak out, and it's kind of embarrassing, but I'm deathly afraid of mice.
I'd say my biggest fear is of losing. Yeah, I hate losing. So whether it be a cross game or high school men's pageant competition, I hate losing.
Biggest fear? I mean, I know it's irrational, but I think losing Mr. WHS is my biggest fear. I mean, come on.
What is my biggest fear? I'd have to go with being alone forever. Or actually, can I change that? I'd have to go with birds, because I'm terrified of birds.
Okay, biggest fear? First one's probably ending up alone, because I love being with people, and that's super sad. Second one is probably not doing, like, not being significant, or because I really want to make an impact in the world and help others, but I can't do that if I'm not important. And third one, freshman year, when my dad tried giving me a haircut, it was horrible. We stopped halfway through. Tiffany Zhang and Emily Saylor, I still remember when you guys laughed at me. Thanks.
My biggest fear is meat, because I'm a vegetarian, and I feel like meat has diseases.
My biggest fear? Probably the crippling realization that life might just be an illusion.
My greatest fear, besides the inevitability of my own death, is probably sharks. They're terrifying. They've got soulless eyes. Very scary.
I'd say one of my biggest weaknesses is setting high expectations for myself, and I would say that my fear would go along with that being I would not accomplish those dreams and aspirations that I always set for myself.
I have really bad stage fright. I just can't perform in front of people.
My biggest fear would definitely be rejection. I mean, I haven't personally experienced it. I can only imagine what it would feel like. But I bet it would suck, but I wouldn't know.
It is now time for our final category, formal wear. At this time, we'd like to remind you that it is last chance to put in your vote. Please see your pamphlet for directions.
Here comes our first formal contestant. John looks dashing as he's accompanied by his grandmother, Madeline.
Oh!
would like to show our last interview of the night while this is occurring. How about one last round of applause for our contestants?
What I probably miss most about Westboro is my mom's home-cooked meals, my bed, my family, some of the teachers I had, and my third period nap every day.
The thing I'll miss most about WHS is probably the people. Like, coming in every morning and seeing everyone you know that you're friendly with, and just being able to, like, be comfortable in a school zone where some people don't have that opportunity. So definitely gonna miss the people a lot.
I think I'm gonna miss most about Westboro. Quiet town, never much to do, but you get a car, you get some good friends, you always manage to get in something.
The thing I'll miss most about Westboro High School is the insane amounts of busy work that I have to do every night.
It sounds really cheesy and stuff, but I probably have to say I'd like miss all my friends at Westboro High School here, because it's like one of the last times we'll all be together for like 5 days of the week. So I'll miss all of you.
Free time, I'm a big sports guy. Anything athletic, bowling, mini golf, you know, good competitive game of curling until it's been time.
I'm going to miss Arpita Joyce.
What would I miss most about Westboro High School? I'd say the aquarium, probably.
What I'll miss most about going off to college and being away from Westboro is just being away from home, you know? Being away from your own bed, your family, home-cooked meals, the spaghetti and meatballs, that's what I'll miss most, I think.
The thing I'm going to miss most about Westboro High School is always coming into such a positive and enthusiastic learning environment, where there's always going to be people who are going to support you and root for you to succeed. And all the boys.
Oh, it's already recording. Okay, just roll with it and we'll edit it.
Jazz College, it's a small one. Chill out break, cafeteria getting breakfast pizza. After fifth period, with my math bros chilling at the balcony. You know, so those times where I say hi to Sammy, the inner suicide back. Never.
goes. I'm donating all that to charity. I'm earning my own $1 million.
Julia.
Honestly, just this. Just like such a thick ferret.
Stage a couple of people who made this production happen.
We would like to thank Alice Ray and Sarah Bach for being our wonderful choreographers.
We would also like to thank Sheila Orlando and Lily Pashapour for being our tech crew.
Editing the videos, and Michael Young for handling the soundboard.
For helping create the videos and running the technical parts of the program.
Thank you.
for working all year to help produce and run this show. They put in so much work, and it's definitely paid off tonight.
Such great people in helping us out through this whole process. The results are in. We are now going to announce the winners of the Mr. WHS competition.
Speech. All right. I just want to thank everyone who's worked so hard on this project. All these guys, they're awesome. It was awesome doing this. I didn't know it'd be this fun. And a few other people I want to thank. I want to thank Alex Bebko and Grace Green, because they helped me do this dance that I did up here. And without them, I would not have been able to do it. Alex also did Spotlight, which was awesome. And one last thing, I want to say a quote from my favorite movie, Rocky. Yo, Adrian, I did it!
Boy, you should know.